Hey, this is Jody Hoagland, PowerStore Global Evangelist for Dell Technologies. I want to talk to you today a little bit about what we're doing with NVMe over TCP, particularly in PowerStore, but also what we're doing across the landscape of our product portfolio for storage and smart fabric storage software. This is a really cool capability that only Dell Technologies has brought to the table in the industry. So although we've been doing this with PowerStore for a little over a year, we're actually taking things to the next level and giving customers opportunities that they've never thought possible with IP connected storage. All right, so as I mentioned, we want to talk about NVMe over TCP, what we're doing with it with PowerStore, and what some of the benefits are that the market is adapting to because of the capabilities of NVMe over TCP. So specifically, this is a technology that PowerStore is not new to. We actually brought this capability to market back in February of 2022. So we've actually been doing this for over a year. This is something that we've been working with industry partners, like for example, VMware. We actually released this kind of at the same time when VMware released this back last year with vSphere 7.0 Update 3. We actually had an alignment with that release with PowerStore OS that brought in that capability. And since then, we've started to see uptick in adoption of this capability. Now, looking at it and asking the question of what exactly is NVMe over TCP? Now, most people are familiar with technologies like iSCSI, for example. And iSCSI giving you the capability to leverage Ethernet and connect your storage array via a block protocol over Ethernet connectivity, leveraging an IP stack. But now we've kind of progressed into say, hey, let's take this to the next level with NVMe over TCP. So first and foremost, it's important to realize that NVMe over TCP is not iSCSI. It is a completely separate protocol written from the ground up to leverage capabilities that are brought into the environment via NVMe. So this gives us the ability to start framing up context for high performance, low latency networks for storage and compute environments. And specifically, if we look at what's going on with connectivity options like 25 gig Ethernet and 100 gig Ethernet. What we're looking at there is customers that are having conversations with me practically on a daily basis saying, hey, Jody, you know, we're leveraging Fibre Channel today. We've got 32 gig fabrics, but our data center 2.0 vision is actually going to be really focused on high performance, low latency, Ethernet connectivity. And NVMe over TCP is driving that type of connectivity option, and it's driving that conversation. And one of the particular reasons why is if you look at the fact that you have a storage array or a couple of different storage arrays within your ecosystem, and then you've got your compute farm, your servers, you know, our great PowerEdge portfolio that's sitting here, the ability to take and connect those and leverage the connectivity methodology of, if that's direct connect, it could be NVMe over TCP. But here we're talking about the ability to now create a fabric. And this is what gets customers really interested in this technology. In fact, if you look at it kind of holistically from an industry perspective, IDC, a well-known third-party analyst, their projections are that by 2025, you're actually going to see NVMe over TCP be the dominant block protocol in the data center. Meaning that there's anticipation by third-party analysts and other providers out there that we're gonna see NVMe over TCP in the next couple of years overtake the fiber channel implementation methodologies in the core data centers. Now, what's driving that? One, it is that lower cost, right? So we're talking about driving down the cost per port, but we're driving up the performance at the same time. The other aspect of that is what we can do with connectivity options. So now you could be talking about having connections that are out here at edge-based locations, or even cloud-based locations, because it is running over TCP. So if we're taking and running over TCP IP connectivity, but we're leveraging NVMe protocol, we can now extend that out to the edge, extend that out to the cloud, run that in the core data center, And that sets us up for a lot of cool capabilities that had just simply never existed before in the data center environment. Having a low latency, high performance protocol that doesn't have the isolated challenges that a fiber channel network traditionally has. Now, this fabric capability is something that Dell Technologies has engineered and brought to market, and it's something we call SFSS, or Smart Fabric Storage Software. And Smart Fabric Storage Software, again, is an industry first. It's a capability that Dell Technologies pioneered and allows customers to now leverage IP connected storage in a very autonomous fashion. In ways in the past, it was only capable with fiber channel. Now, one of the common challenges, particularly if customers have leveraged iSCSI, iSCSI wasn't the most performant protocol out there. However, it was very simple to implement and simple to use. But once you get above, say, 10, 20, 30, 50, 60 host connections, that's all manual point-to-point connectivity. What Smart Fabric allows you to do is now say, hey, let me take that and say, I've got now, tens of hosts, dozens of hosts, hundreds of hosts, even thousands of hosts. That's just practically unmanageable in an iSCSI-based implementation. But with Smart Fabric Storage Software and NVMe over TCP, we now have the art of possible. So logging into Smart Fabric Storage Software gives you a common interface and pane of glass, which, by the way, is a nice little HTML5-based GUI, where you can now do autonomous discovery, mapping, zoning, all from one place. Something that's only ever been possible in fiber channel fabrics has now been brought to enterprise low latency connected NVMe over TCP storage. So that's what's going on. I would encourage you to take a deeper look at what is happening in the industry with NVMe over TCP. If you want some more details, definitely check us out at DellTechnologies.com, but also my LinkedIn profile, Jody Hoagland on LinkedIn. All of my blog posts are out there specifically for PowerStore, and then recently one article around NVMe over TCP made simple with VMware and PowerStore and how all that works. So hope this is helpful. Reach out, let me know if you've got any questions. Have a great day.